Mr. Speaker, Aboriginal communities deserve better than rhetoric from this government, Mr. Speaker. Their concerns are in fact very legitimate. As for me, Mr. Speaker, all too often I've seen the forces of law and order call our protests illegal. So, I wouldn't be surprised if they tried to lump us in with the terrorists. Will the minister finally realize that C-51 is unconstitutional and that it threatens the rights of Indigenous people? The Honourable Minister of Public Safety. Mr. Speaker, I would like to tell my colleague that I was proud to serve within the Department of Aboriginal Affairs to help Aboriginal peoples, and I invite him to read page 3 of the bill, Mr. Speaker, which clearly indicates that activities to undermine Canada's security do not include lawful advocacy, protest, dissent, or artistic expression. And obviously, Mr. Speaker, we reject that argument every time, because when we talk about security, if we say that security menaces our, or threatens our freedom, there are many provisions in C-51, Mr. Speaker, particularly when it comes to processes not only of examination but of judicial supervision. I would invite my colleague to read the bill and to support measures that not only will protect Canadians but will also strengthen oversight mechanisms.